Welcome all. Today is 26 April 2020, the 10th centenary of Srinivasa Ramanujan, the great mathematician. So I would like to share some notes on his history. He was born on 22nd December 1887 into a Tamil Brahmin Iyengar family in Erode. He had no proper schooling and no formal training in mathematics, but he had made great contributions in the field of mathematical analysis, infinite series, number theory, and many more. During his school days, the book A Synopsis of Elementary Results in Pure and Applied Mathematics by G.S. Carr had made a great impression on him, and it was a book that awakened the genius in him. During his early ages itself, he had started doing problems in equations, theory of equations, and started solving these equations. And his results were published in the Journal of the Indian Mathematical Society with the help of one of his friends. Being deeply religious, he always said that an equation for me has no meaning unless it expresses a thought of God. He said that everything that he wrote in his book was given by the goddess in his dreams. In 1930, he sent his works to G.H. Hardy at the University of Cambridge. Initially, Hardy did not give much importance to these letters, but after going through these letters deeply, he was impressed by Ramanujan's work and he wanted to invite Ramanujan to England. And after reading these letters, Hardy concluded that the letters were certainly the most remarkable he had received and that Ramanujan was a mathematician of the highest quality. After receiving the invitation, Ramanujan was not interested to go to England as he should leave India. But later he accepted the invitation and went to the University of Cambridge to work with G.H. Hardy. And there, his works on highly composite numbers was published in the Proceedings of the London Mathematical Society. In 1970, he was elected to the London Mathematical Society, and a few months later, he was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society. Also, he was elected a Fellow of Trinity College, Cambridge. During his lifetime, Ramanujan was always suffering from many diseases. And at the time when he was in England, Ramanujan suffered from tuberculosis, and after getting treatment from England, he went back to his native place in India. But unfortunately, he died at the age of 32 on 26 April 1920. And the world lost a great mathematician. Now, we will look at some of his great contributions to the world of mathematics.
Some remarkable contributions of Dr. Srinivasa Ramanujan. When Hardy told Ramanujan that his vehicle number, say 1729, now known as Ramanujan's number, is unlucky, Ramanujan replied in happiness that it is the smallest natural number which can be expressed as the sum of two distinct cubes of natural numbers in this form. You see, 1729 is 1 cube plus 12 cube, also 9 cube plus 10 cube. And no natural number less than 1729 has this property. Yes, that's wonderful. Also, in 1910, his remarkable contribution is that he found an infinite series for pi. That is, this infinite series approximates 8 decimal places of pi. Another major contribution of Ramanujan is in partition of numbers. He found an asymptotic formula for P of n, where P of n is the partition of n. It is given as P of n is asymptotically equal to 1 by 4 pi root 3 e raised to pi root of 2 pi by 3 as n tends to infinity. Next contribution is Ramanujan's congruences. He had given three congruences for partition functions. P of 5n plus 4 is always congruent to 0 mod 5. P of 7n plus 5 is always congruent to 0 mod 7. And P of 11n plus 6 is always congruent to 0 mod 11 for any natural number n. He was almost to prove Goldberg's conjecture. He proved that every large number can be written as sum of at most 4 primes. Goldberg's conjecture states that every natural number greater than or equal to 4, that is even, can be written as sum of 2 primes. This shows that every large number can be written as sum of at most 4 primes. More than this, he also worked on hypergeometric series, Bernoulli numbers, Fermat's last theorem, which states that no real numbers x, y, z exist such that x raised to n plus y raised to n equals z raised to n for n greater than 2. But Ramanujan proved a subcase, that is, there exist no three natural numbers x, y, z that satisfy x raised to n plus y raised to n equal to z raised to n for any n greater than 2. One of his interesting contributions is Ramanujan's magic square. What do you mean by a magic square? Magic square is an n by n matrix arrangement where each column sum, each row sum and each diagonal sum must be the same number, which will be some number a constant. Here, Ramanujan had made a magic square with first row as his date of birth. That is 22-12-1887. December 22nd, 1887 is birthdate. This is a super magic square, not even a magic square. This is a super magic square because we see that when we are adding all rows, all columns, all diagonals, we get 139, which is a prime. Also, when we add this 4 boxes, again we get 139. When we add these 4 boxes, again we get 139. Now, similar is the case for these boxes. Also, similar is the case for the corner angles. This is a nice property for his date of birth. And we can try for our date of birth also. We will get a magic square, but the diagonal entries, rows and columns will give you a number, but it is not necessarily true that all these square sums will give the same number. And this is a specialty with his date of birth also. Moreover that, 139 is again a prime number. That's a great appreciation to Ramanujan's magic number. A great salute to the master of numbers, Dr. Srinivas Ramanujan.